Okay, so this is my friend's HD 4870 graphic card. We got this huge problem going on where the temperature just won't stay down. GPU fan was going at 100% and it still goes over 100 degrees Celsius and all that craziness. So took it apart, reapply paste and everything, doesn't do nothing. The modifications and stuff like that doesn't do nothing. So after some careful examination on this card, I realized a couple of the screws, the screw hole is cracked. Let me unscrew that and show you what I mean. So this direction, do you see that little crack? So it's cracked, same thing to this one. Therefore obviously the cooler is not installed properly and it doesn't help the cooling. So I have no choice but to buy a new cooler. My friend offered me a tray and then I bought her a cooler off ncx.com. It's an Arctic Cooling Accelero S1 Reversion 2 GPU cooler. It's a passive cooler, fanless, but you know, I'm just gonna mod a fan on or something like that. Maybe you can even put two 120s. I don't know, I gotta get it installed first. It supports 4870, so that will be alright on this card. Back out the packaging, come with a case badge, that's nice. Memory heat sinks, some more memory heat sinks at the front. Hey, what is that? Imperfection. I didn't even open this package yet. Do you see that mark on the thermal paste? That's not cool. Anyways, that shouldn't affect anything. The GPU core is very small. The order came with the Maximum PC DIY Guide. Hands-on projects for PC building, upgrading, and tweaking. So, it's an overview and some descriptions and some details on how to overclock your computer and build your system. It may come in handy to anybody that's new to overclocking. It's like a yes and no thing, because not all the case are built the same way, and not all the motherboard are built the same way, or the cooler brackets, you know, there's just so many things are different. Like get ready, set, and build section where they show you how to build your computer, where the what was the part that I was looking at? Where how to install the CPU fan is not always the same way. What if you have AMD? I only got an example for the Intel processor. And not everybody's case works like this. You know, it could be just a simple screw to put them in. And this one is more of a fancy one, so you can take the hard drive compartment off and put your hard drive in. So yeah, if you want to build your own system for the first time, or if you're new to this whole computer building and overclocking thing, just do some research on Google. But this will be a nice guide to begin with though. But again, do your research on Google, something specific to the parts you're buying, instead of relying on a guidebook like this. But it's nice to have. There are screws on the side where you can adjust where the screw holes you want it to be. I guess that will help you install on various different type of video cards, which those kind of designs will help the product to support as much type of video card as possible. Well, it's installed, looks nice. Gonna add some fan on. One thing to talk about, if you have a graphic card and the memory is right at that spot, it will block the heatsink from, sorry, it will block the heat pipe from the heatsink. And I bended the heatsink for memory a little bit, it will fit properly, but I hope it doesn't decrease performance too much. But just a little note, if you have this cooler that you might encounter, depends on your graphic card. So it's in the running, only with the assistance of 120mm fan. It's not even a high RPM fan, something off a power supply. Because I know the passive is not going to be good enough for 4870. 4870 seems to be pretty hot. Okay, let's see about the benchmark. Okay, so I have real-time HDR demo 1.2 running. As full screen as I can, so I can see these two stats. 1920 times 1000. GPU activity is at 95%, so it's pretty much full. And the temperature, I already actually have it running for a while now, so. And the temperature right now, it's at 79 degrees Celsius. And the memory is 75, the shutter is 64. This is a lot better than before with the original cooler. A broken original cooler. Seems to be between 78 and 79 stable. Which is acceptable for such a cheap cooler. This cooler costs $29 Canadian and it'll probably be much cheaper than the United States. So assuming if you have couples of really good fans, a high RPM fan installed onto the card, then I'm sure you can get a really good result to even to overclock the card. But we're talking about default settings and everyday gaming, this temperature is acceptable for the price. I am going to have this video card for just one night, so I will not do any further extreme testing on the cooler. But this gives you an idea what this cooler can do. But this is not in the passive mode, remember. I put a 100mm fan on it. Just one. Just keep the air going, basically. And this is the result you get.